Hi guys, in the last session, we just had a very brief discussion about basics, identities, about language, string, and alphabet. So let us continue this discussion where in this session, I'll try to specify few information about language. From thereafter, I directly jump to design of automatas specifically. Okay, now. As discussed in the last class, when I say the word language, you told or we discussed already, language is a set of strings formed with a specific alphabet. Now, we should first consider an alphabet. On that, we make a string. Then we identify the languages. The question is, how do you make languages? If you can able to recall from the previous session, I had written something like sigma star, where sigma indicates alphabet. Suppose if sigma is 0, 1, I said sigma star could be union of sigma power 0, sigma power 1, sigma power 2, and so on. Now, when I use a word language, language could be subset from sigma star. That means, I may have to consider a language from the set of strings available in sigma star, where to get a language we try to impose or we try to restrict or we try to give some condition. Say for example, if sigma is 0 1, I can say sigma star could be 0 1 0 0 1 1 0 1 1 0 1 0 1, it goes on of any length. Say if I want to make a language, then I say language with strings starting with 0. Then I can say L1 could be only those strings taken from the sigma star, say 0, 0, 0. 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, it goes on. Suppose next string with strings ending with 0, 1. That is a condition. Then it could be L2 could be 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1. 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, something like this. Clearly observe in both the things, both the languages are subset of sigma star, but these languages are framed depending on the condition. So obviously I can say languages are subset of sigma star. And again, if you say language is this, I should understand two important things. One, what is empty language and what is empty string? Both are different. Anyhow, we define empty language with null, empty string as epsilon. Where when I say empty language, it is a language without any symbols, without any strings, but empty string is a language with a symbol epsilon, where epsilon indicate no input symbols. Okay, this is about the languages, basics of it. Next session we'll discuss about the automata, its representation. Thank you.